just by doing that, look at the difference in brightness.
These solar garden or pathway lights that you can pick up for only a few dollars a piece seem like a very good deal, and you can actually get other ones that are cheaper. These I have gotten for, I think these are about a dollar a piece, and they seem like a very good deal and very convenient. You just stake them in the ground and they charge up during the day, and there's an internal battery and it works at night. Until you get them home and put them in and realize they're not very bright, and they also don't last very long. Well, both of those things can be fixed. In this video, I'm going to show you how to make them light up brighter, and you only need a few parts. So let's get started. First thing you'll notice is I have this one ready to go, and turn it off, and you notice it's not very bright. And the light that you're seeing is from the monitor over there that I'm using to preview the video on. So if that gives you any indication of brightness. So let's turn this on and let's take this apart. Now you gotta realize these are built on a very strict budget. If you can pick these up for a couple dollars a piece, it probably takes less than a dollar to build. The solar panels are extremely inexpensive for them to purchase or manufacture. They only put out a very small amount of power. This battery that they come in, that comes included is a 200 milliamp hour NiCad battery. So these don't last very long at all. They're very, very cheap. LED, not the greatest as far as brightness is concerned. Now very simply, the way this works is when the solar cell sees light, it charges the battery. When it does not see light, this little chip here allows current to pass through the circuit, and it's known as a buck boost converter, and it will take the 1.2 volts that this battery puts out, because it is a NiCad, so it doesn't put out 1.5, it puts out 1.2 volts, and it brings it up to something around 3 volts. At low current so that this LED can operate. There's no such thing as free energy, so you get more voltage but you lose current, or you can up the current but you lose voltage. So in this case you're losing current, but that's okay because you're only driving a small LED, so it works great. Now what we're going to do is change out this inductor so we get a little bit more current, less voltage, but it's going to light this LED up a little bit brighter. It's going to make it work a little bit harder. This LED is actually not very good, and I'd like to swap it out for another LED, but we're gonna just change the inductor first just to see the difference that it makes. Now, where do you get inductors? Now, you can order some inductors or just do what I did. And I hope this focuses because I'm doing something different today. I'm hoping this camera can actually focus. I actually just took them off an old camcorder that I'm using. I save old circuit boards and old components that don't work just for the parts. As you'll see, I took some off the board here. And yes, they look different than what's on here, but it's the same thing. These are SMDs, these are surface mount devices. So I took some off of here. Now this is a 270 microhenry inductor. So I have a bunch here. This is a 22 micro. This is, and you can't see it on camera, at least I can try to get it there, but there's writing on the top, but it's very hard to see in person, especially if you don't have a microscope, but it's very faint. This is a 33. What is this? This is a 47. I can't even read that one. So they're close enough. So we're going to go from a 270 microhenry to something like a 33. I'm going to say anything between 20 and 50 is actually good. You're not really going to notice too much of a difference. Now, because these are surface mount devices, they're going to be a little bit more of a pain in the butt to get on here, but it's what I got. If you can find any more like this, it'll make your life that much easier. But I don't have anything like that, so. So let's get this over here, and I'll show you how to do this. Alright, so first things first, let's get the old one out. The old ones out. So I'm gonna go. This one looks like it's broken. Although it shouldn't matter. It's only an LED that we're powering. What is this? This is a 47. This is a 33. We'll go with the 33. I'm sure someone's going to yell at me for doing it this way, but it's a solar light. I'm not too concerned. I'm just going to put a dab of super glue. Just a tiny little dab. And that's actually a little too much, but we'll live. I'm going to mount this upside down. So that the terminals are exposed. Nice and flat so it doesn't roll off. What is that? And all the super glue there is just to hold it in place until we solder it. Okay, now while that dries, I'm going to take a piece of solid wire, copper wire, and tin it. Now I'm just going to take this wire and bend it a little bit. You can use stranded, I just like to use solid, it just works better for me. Let's tin the end of this. Get to see my amazing soldering skills. Yeah. Amazingly sloppy soldering skills. As you'll see, I am not the world's greatest solder. I'm doing this all my life and I'm still sloppy at it. It's kind of like my handwriting, but it gets the job done, and that's all that really matters. Okay, so now that they're on, the other thing I'm going to do is upgrade the battery. So I have these nickel metal hydride batteries. These are 850 milliamp hours. Washington first. I'm not going to screw that all the way in. I'm just going to put it in here so we can have a comparison between the two. And remember, this is with the stock LED. Let's take this off and turn this on. Lights. And look, just by doing that, this is the one with the new coil, same LED. This is the stock one. Just by doing that, look at the difference in brightness. I mean, that is incredible. Now, this is going to be pulling more current, so it's going to drain the battery faster. But remember, I just put a better battery in here. So as long as this gets heavy sun throughout the day or direct sun throughout the day, it should be able to charge that battery most of the way up. And you'll get plenty of juice throughout the night, so it should stay on most of the night. Some might be saying, well, you didn't swap the battery on the other one. All right, well, let's swap the battery on the other one. I already know the outcome. I don't know if you can hear that, but just suddenly got a crazy rainstorm. There, I won't put the whole thing back on, I'll just leave it like that, just to give you an idea. There you go, same thing. It's still brighter. And like I said, the light that you're seeing over here is actually the light from the monitor, so if that tells you what a difference that is. Look at that. That would be the reflection on the ground, and then there's this one. Big difference. You can't even see the reflection on the other one. Something I thought of afterwards, that's actually a good idea to do, is water will actually get behind this panel. So what a lot of people do is use some clear packing tape and cut it and put it over this panel, and that is not a bad idea. Another thing you can do is put some hot glue on the inside of this, as well as this little chip got bent over, as well as bypass this switch. The switch is worthless. Who's going to go out and turn off all their garden lights? Also, the switch will get corroded over time and just cause you problems. So the best thing to do is just bypass it. And that's what I'm going to do now. And to do that, you'll notice there's three legs. This one does nothing. Let's see if I can get that. And we got a wicked thunderstorm going on outside. Let's see how close I can get before it gets blurry. It looks like I was already there. Okay. So this leg, you'll notice, does nothing, but then these two. So what happens is when it's turned off, it connects these two legs. So no current flows. When you turn it on, it connects these two legs. So all we want to do is go and bridge. I don't have this propped up very well. Just use some solder to bridge those two. That now, no matter where you move the switch, it's always going to be turned on. Obviously, if it's sunny out, the LED's not going to be turned on. So that part of it's still going to work. This just isn't going to turn the LED off at night, which, I mean, who's going to go out at night and turn off, open up all their garden lights and turn them on? the other thing, let's drop, I don't know how hot this is. I just turned it on. I'm gonna drop some of this hot glue in there over these holes. Just to plug them up. To keep water from getting in. They already have some silicone in there, but it apparently isn't good enough, and it can use any of the, you know, all the help it can get. And then you just patch it back up and put it away. Or put it in your garden, I should say. Together. Notice no matter what I do, it stays on. So we don't want the switch getting corroded. And once again, check out the difference. This one has been modified, this one has not. Look how much brighter. And that part will run you about 3 cents if you were to actually buy them in bulk. Or, like I said, find them someplace. Coupled with the bigger battery, it should work just the same as before, just brighter.